Hey y'all, it's Steve, Hobo with Wood. I received an email asking me to help someone understand optimize selected shapes. How do you use it, when to use it, and what does it do? So hang around, this is gonna be a quick one. So in the edit menu, there is a tool for optimize selected shapes. There's also a setting in the offset tool for optimizing results. Optimizing and simplifying, I think is what it says. What is optimization and how does it work? What does it do when it does what it does? Well, let's think about it like you're giving the laser a set of directions. So I come up with an example here, and I'm gonna give you some directions to the mall. I've got two different examples here. So let's switch over here. Switch. All right, go to my notepad. All right, these are directions to the mall. Starting from the home ramp of exit 19, accelerate down the on-ramp, then immediately cross all lanes of traffic to the far left lane. Travel in this lane for 120 meters. Move over to the center lane for 60 meters. Return to the far left lane for 30 meters. Cross over to the far right lane for 22 meters. Then back to the center lane for 11 meters. Now rapidly exit the highway at exit 20 from the center lane. Turn right at the top of the ramp. Travel for 1 mile and make a U-turn. After driving 3/4 mile, the mall will be on your right. This will get you to the mall. Might create some road rage events and maybe a wreck or two. Rapid acceleration and wasted fuel, energy, all kinds of good stuff. But it'll get you there. Now let's look at another set of directions to the same mall from the same starting point. Directions to the mall. From exit 19, stay in the far right lane and take exit 20. At the top of the exit ramp, turn right. The mall is 1/4 mile on the left. Same directions, same destination. Got you there, three sets of instructions instead of all that lane changing and rapid. Whole lot simpler because it was optimized. That last one was an optimal set of instructions on how to get where you need to be. So when you optimize a shape, you're doing the same thing. When you have a shape in Lightburn, it's created using a whole bunch of nodes. And the nodes are telling it, is it a line? Is it a curve? Is it an arc? What is it? What's it doing? And telling it what to do till it gets to the next node or the next set of instructions, such as the first one, lane change, this. So with the fewer sets of instructions, the fewer lane changes, the fewer nodes, you're sending less information to the laser. It's going to be a much more efficient, it is the optimal design. So how can this benefit you? Well, with fewer nodes, you have a smoother design. And this can come in real handy whenever you're using the trace feature. Or if you've got a design that's got some unnecessary nodes and you just really need to clean it up. So let's take a look at a couple of different examples. So if I go over into Lightburn, this is a text actually. It's from my Dino's font. And there are some irregularities in this. Like that I'd want smoothed out. I don't need that all jagged up like that. And There's a few more places like that here. That's unnecessary. It's not smooth. And there are places that you can do this. Now, you can do this with node editing. If I select this piece here and I go to my node editor, now you can see there's one extra node in there that can go away. So if I can just select that and hit the letter D, that'll clean that up. But it's got that in there. It's kind of just, I need to pull that out. And so that helps. That made that smoother. But I can do the same thing with selecting that, edit, optimize selected shapes. In fact, I want to pull this over here where you can see it. So I got that. Now, I got this area here that I'm wanting to clean up. Selected it, edit, optimize selected shapes. Now it's going to pull up this menu, and it's giving you three things that you can do: smooth source shapes, fit shapes to lines, and fit shapes to arcs. Right now it's telling you there are 114 points, 32 lines, and 82 curves. And as you start to change this, you'll see that we went from 114 points to 52 points, but we got a lot of straight jagged lines there because we did all this fit shape to lines. And I don't want all them lines in there, so I'm gonna take that back down. Now we're gonna fit shapes to arcs. That didn't do a whole lot of anything. We got rid of 4 points. So I'll put this up some, and we're gonna increase this. And we'll increase this. Nah. Still better, but I'm not getting, I'm getting straight lines. See, I turned that straight from an arc. If I take that back down, there's the arc. There's a more arc. But let's take this all the way back to the beginning. Turn on smooth source shapes. Look at that, how smooth all that is. And now I can get rid of, don't want to do that. Let's see, come back. There we go. We'll bring them all to the middle. So that's gotten rid of all those extra nodes. Everything's really nice and smooth and curved. And that looks good right there. Say, okay. So I went from 114 points to 44 points. So all those extra lane changes have been eliminated. And we went from 32 lines to 18 lines, and from 82 curves to 26 curves. Say okay, come back out and look at that, and that's much cleaner, much nicer. It's a whole lot smoother. Now we can do the same thing to this piece. Edit, optimize selected shapes. I'm going to turn on my smooth source shapes. And now I'll just kind of, let's just bring it up about middle. So that's got everything really nice and smooth, but there's all those nodes in there. We went from 110 points to 626 points. So now we're going to start eliminating some of those. Let's give them some arcs. And that looks pretty good. I got corners where I need them. I need a little bit more arc. And a little bit less line. That gives me the desired look I'm looking for. Say okay. And here we got, that's kind of funky. Those are all funky. I'm just going to grab all of those. Edit, optimize selected shapes, smooth source shapes, come into the middle, and see, I don't want that because that's giving me all those lines. I don't want, these are all circles, so I want to keep it to arcs. There, that looks good, about middle to middle. And I've gone from 48 points to 22 points, 13 lines to 3, and 35 curves to 19. And that looks so much better. There's still a point right there that's not quite a curve, but that looks a lot better than all this wonky over here. So if I grab that, and in fact, you don't have to do individual shapes. I'm just showing you this, what it does when it does it. So if you just grab the whole thing and say optimize selected shapes, turn on the original. See how smooth all that looks right there? And then we'll give it all about midpoint. I find that works usually pretty good for me. Sometimes it requires some additional tweaking. Just say okay. And that smoothed up a lot of that. That's still kind of funky right there and there, but that helped the overall image considerably. Undo. I do want to keep those points up there, but so that's the one downside to doing them all at one time. You may end up getting some mixed results. So edit, we'll do all these, optimize selected shapes, turn on smooth source shapes, and I put it all in about the middle. And that gives me a pretty good result. And now back down. Let's actually, we'll go up here. And sometimes you'll have to go back and actually manually tweak to get your desired result. And I lost those points coming up in there, so let's go back there and we'll grab this and bring it up here, give it a little bit of curve. Smooth that out with the letter S. There we go, something like that. But that's what, and that's under edit and optimize selected shapes. So that's how you can clean up your designs and get rid of the irregularities and all the extra nodes and the if you've done traces and you get those little spikes where they jut out where it didn't trace real clean, you can use this optimized selected shapes to clean up your image. If you have a trace that you've done and you select it and you go to optimize selected shapes and you're not seeing anything, that may be because everything's still grouped. So ungroup your traced image or your design and then select one or more of those lines and then you'll be able to see your nodes. But if it's a group, you won't see the nodes and you won't have an effective outcome or any outcome. So unselect it, optimize selected shapes in the edit menu, and I'll turn on that first tab. I think default it's off, turn it on, and get everything nice and round there. And I find that for the most part, there's always exceptions, but for the most part, if I just put everything right in the middle, smooths everything up, cleans it up, looks really nice. May need a little bit of tweaking, but I've also, as I showed you there, sometimes when you select the entire thing and try to do the entire image that way, not all those lines respond in a manner that you would give you the result you're looking for. So sometimes you might need to do individual lines to get your desired result. So I hope you found this helpful. Hope you found it informative. And again, this was a request for how do you do this? Well, this is how you use optimized selected shapes. Again, hope you found it informative. I'm Steve, Hobo with Wood. and I'll see you in the next video. I'm out.